Okay, let's do some math for fun. And here I have this limit for you guys. And in fact, I just created this limit today. Let's have a look. We have the limit as x approaches infinity of 1 over 1 minus, ready? Cosine of ln of sine of inverse tangent of e to the x squared power. Yeah. And I really want to put this on my calculus 1 quiz for my calculus 1 students. But I'm not going to do that because this is week 3 only. I don't want to scare them away. So that's why I'm making the video. Anyway, go ahead and pause the video and try this first and let me know what you get. Done? If you did it, let me know. Alright, so let's just do a usual business. Let's put infinity to this x here and then hopefully you can reason things out along the way. So we're looking at 1 minus cosine of ln of sine of inverse tangent of e to the infinity square power and then 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Yeah, and then on the top we have 1. Cool, now let's try to reason each and every step out. Do this inside out. Infinity square is still infinity. E to the infinity's power is infinity. And then if we have inverse tangent of infinity, that means we are looking at the horizontal asymptote for inverse tangent, and we have horizontal asymptote at pi over 2. So that will give us pi over 2. Then we look at sine of pi over 2, which is very nicely equal to 1. Then we look at ln of 1. I told you it's not bad, right? Ln 1 is what? Is 0. And then we are looking at cosine of 0, and cosine of 0 is just equal to 1. So we are going to get that this will be approaching 1 over that one in blue minus this one in red. And we know 1 minus 1 is 0. So this is approaching. We have a 0 on the bottom and then a 1 on the top. And now what? Well, this is not undefined because we are trying to do a limit. 1 over 0, in fact, it's an indicator that we may get infinity or negative infinity, right? This is actually a good limit form, but we will have to reason it out. So in fact, we have to go back here and then do this one carefully because we have to look for the sign of this. Is it positive or negative? So let's look back here. This positive infinity, yeah? And then when we have inverse tangent of infinity, well, let's have a look at the picture. So inverse tangent looks about like this. We have the vertical horizontal asymptote here. But as you can see, as x is approaching infinity, the curve is approaching pi over 2, but from the bottom. So in fact, the pi over 2 is a little bit less than pi over 2. So I will say that's pi over 2 minus. So it's right here, like this. And then let's look at sine of pi over 2. But a little bit less than that. So let's take a look at the unit circle. So we have the unit circle right here. Pi over 2 is 90 degrees, but it's a little bit less than that. So it's a little bit right here. We are approaching pi over 2 from the negative side. So it's from 0 radian to pi over 2 like this. Well, the y value here is 1, but this is almost there. So that means the y value is approaching 1 from the bottom. Therefore, this one is a little bit less than that. So it's 1 minus. All right, and then ln of 1 minus, let's have a look. Ln, it looks like this. Here is the 1. And 1 minus, meaning we are coming toward 1 from the left-hand side. So it's somewhat like this. So it's approaching 0, the y value, but it's from the bottom. So this is 0 minus. Lastly, cosine of 0 minus. Alright, let's go back to the unit circle. 0 radian is this right here, and then 0 minus means that we are approaching 0 from the negative radian, which is like this. So it's somewhere right here. Meaning, this right here, the x value here is 1, but this right here is almost there. So it's actually less than 1. So in fact, this one is 1 minus. So if you are in Calc 1, if you are starting calculus for the very first time, if you can follow each and every steps, great job, all right? And I think this is really a lot of fun, and then I did go over all the things with my students in my class. I think it's a lot of fun. And then, well, Natanya, okay. 1 minus. Put that right here. This is 1 minus. Everybody knows 1 minus 1 is 0. By now, 1 minus 1 minus is 0 plus. Why? Because this, just think about it as 0.9999. 1 minus that is positive small number, so 0 plus. Therefore, 1 divided by 0 plus, that will give us positive infinity. So, this limit is equal to positive infinity, like this. So what do you think?